to watch them.
I will show it so you can play it.
No, Chuck, what? Like, why?
Wait, that was interesting.
Where the heck is
one
it?
One of them was 2D, and the other one was 3D.
We can't do
it. Oh, we can't.
It closed the computer.
Why would you...
The show just came out an hour ago.
Earlier. 2 minutes. Oh, you know what it is? I just have my right stand with it.
That's a curse! A curse! It's a sus! Don't wait!
Oh my god!
It's a reference! Yeah, maybe I'm... Oh my god! It's driven up! Oh my god!
JK Sim...
Just kidding. New trailer for the Chippendale Rescue Rangers movie just dropped, and it looks pretty epic and meta. Do not miss it, May 20th. It's coming out, May 20th. Project RR coming out soon as well. Do not miss it. Economics left.
And Ryan, you're pretty excited for this movie. So.
I am, and I would love to talk about it. So basically what they're doing here, it's very absurd and obscure and, well, it's insane, basically. I don't know if you've seen the trailer or not, but I have, and it was pretty insane. But I think I know what they're doing, and I think that it went was definitely a good one show anyways. So I think the direction that they went, because I think it looks like it's going to be meta. It's no secret that I got the CGI surgery.
Today I'm going to be dumping my mind. For the first time, my thoughts, all of them, on this movie, will be in an entire video. So let's get started. So first we have the trailer here right behind me, and the first time we watch it, we are going to go through it, and I'm not going to mention every little thing that's going to be in this movie, but I'll mention the big things first, okay? Then we'll do frame-by-frame analysis. All right, so you can go ahead and start it.
Real Hollywood.
So, right off the bat, it doesn't even look like a movie trailer. You would think that this is like something else. I don't know, like Real Hollywood Story, what this is right here. So, the first time I saw it, it actually threw me off. I actually did not think this was a trailer at all. So, that was an interesting little thing that they, you know, put in the trailer, as it started off as like a story. Interesting. So you can go ahead and unpause it.
Chippendale Rescue Rangers, the show that defined the generation and turned two unknown chipmunks into international superstars.
So, right off the bat, you just saw it, right? It was a report about the show being popular, right? And then it goes to these two scenes. So if you can go back a few little frames there. Huge room. Now, this is not, I'm going to talk about this later in the frame-by-frame analysis, but just off the bat, it goes from the show being super successful to this room. And that can lead me to think that it's somebody that is a really huge fan of the show's room. And it's also interesting to see like all of the little like knickknacks and everything, and it was super interesting to see the TV, if you go back in just a few more frames. It was super interesting to see the TV there as well. Like this, that was kind of amazing. And it's showing the show on there. And then the theme song is also playing as well. That's just a little touch for the, you know, nostalgia geeks, nostalgia people that love, you know, people that grew up with the show watching this for the first time would be like, oh my gosh, no way. This is the first time that they're on screen in 30 years. Kind of insane. Okay, you can unpause it.
But his success took Chip and Dale to new heights.
To many more seasons of the Rescue Rangers.
We were living the dream.
Go back 2 frames. 3 frames, 4 frames, 5 frames, 6 frames, 7 frames, 8 frames. So what just happened there? We just saw the characters animated for the first time in 30 years. Like actually animated. Made in the last 3 years. Big milestone. I'll talk about what I think about it later, but we can go ahead and watch.
We were living the dream, dancing to Roger Rabbit with Roger Rabbit.
Another huge moment. You just saw Roger Rabbit on there, right? Roger Rabbit. They made a movie in the 90s, 80s, I'm not sure. But that was also monumental, right? This first go around, like I said, I'm just pointing out the big things, the huge things that like the average viewer would see and notice. So you can go ahead and unpause it.
No one ever imagined it could all come crashing down. Torn by vanity.
You look different.
Hey, it's no secret I had to see you answered.
It is no secret that he got the CGI surgery. That is also a monumental moment. Guys, I'm telling you, that is gonna blow up. That is gonna be everywhere. CGI surgery done. He got the CGI surgery done. That is gonna be everywhere. That is gonna go viral. That is gonna make this movie so much better. I promise you. You can go ahead and unpause it.
Consumed by temptation.
Well, love of cheese got the best of me. I just love it so
pause
much.
It. Cheese addiction. Cheese addiction. So, in the original show, from the 1989 to 1992, I think it originally aired, this character that we see, just saw, really liked cheese. And apparently, it looks, I'm going to talk about this in the second thing around, but apparently now he has this addiction to cheese, and maybe that led him to, you know, be, you know, not good, you know, in the future, right, after the show got canceled. And I wanted to point that out as a big thing because it's, like, really interesting to see that they decided to have a character have like an addiction to that, and it's also it's nostalgic and it's funny and it's a reference and it's awesome. Okay, continue.
I just love it so much.
More, please.
Is it possible that two living legends are destined to reunite?
I'm thinking reboot.
Nobody wants a reboot.
Yeah, we saw a lot there in the last 5 seconds, but we'll mention who we saw there in just a few minutes. But big thing, nobody wants a reboot. The agent said, I'm thinking reboot. Nobody wants a reboot. This is what the whole movie is about. It's not going to be a reboot. It's a comeback. That's a huge deal. That's what they're saying. That's what the Lonely Island, the people who are producing this or something, I don't know, but they're definitely involved, are trying to actually do. They're trying to not make a reboot, and like, you know, that Disney has been doing in the last 5 years with all the other movies, and they're actually going to make something original and awesome. So that's a big thing right there.
Reboot!
Rescue Rangers!
You need a disguise or something. Grab the first thing you can.
What? So another big thing, we'll talk about more in detail in a second. Indiana Jones. So in the original show, Chip wore this coat that represented what Indiana Jones wore. And the fact that they just have that and they recognize that, you know, it's actually from Indiana Jones is monumental as well. Pause it, go back 5 frames. Right there, that guy, we're going to talk to him later. What? Who is this man? I think this guy is going to be huge in the movie. We'll talk about it more later. But that guy right there, I don't know, there's something about him. Okay.
Rescue Rangers 2.0.
Okay, like I said, I'm going to go over this again, so it's okay. There was a lot that happened in the last, like, 10 seconds. A lot of people. We'll go over it, don't worry. And by the way, this right here, this, like, little, like, thing, this logo, amazing as well. Yeah, there it is. Look, amazing. You can go ahead and pause it.
This place looks weird.
Remember that animation style where everything looked real but nothing looked right?
Who are you?
Are you talking to us?
Obviously.
But it looks like you're talking to that window.
It actually looks like I'm looking right at you.
Okay.
Look at my eyes, looking right at your eyes.
Yeah.
What a cast. I don't know, what can I say? They brought the big boys. Alright, go ahead. Alright. First time watching that, right? You just like, huh? You have no words. It's just like, there's so many little things, and you're just like, this could actually be something awesome and epic. So now we'll break it down frame by frame, so you can understand a bit. Let's go ahead and restart. You can go frame by frame this time. Fame. So many fame here. Fame. Lots of fame. That's probably going to be in the movie. Fame is probably going to be a big thing in the movie, because it says fame everywhere. This might be a woman, we're not sure. Yeah, we have to do more research on that. Yeah, more fame. Legends, because they are legends, right? They're also, like, you know, living legends, like it'll explain later. Cool little, like, text thing. Hollywood, because this is where they're going to live, right? This is where they live because that's where they live. Okay, this right here. This is the intro to the original 1989 show, and I'm pretty sure this is a typical TV in that time, too. So those little details, right? Those little details of, like, having the TV from that time period as well, it just you know, just a touch. The wall in the background, right? Wood, right? 90s, wood, right? Right. Here's the intro playing again as well. Also, you can't hear it because we're going frame by frame, but like I said, the original music from the actual show, the intro music is playing. Right, they're going through the little thing, they're doing all the things that they would do. This is from the pilot episode, it seems, because it is the original intro. There were two different intros. They remade it halfway through. Right there, you know, there's them looking over, right? Okay, so here is a big thing. So in the cast on IMDb, it says that there is a fan. Just F-A-N, like probably a fan of the show. So my theory is that this is the fan's room. And also, look at this map right here. Look at all the locations that they've been. Almost like they're like tracking down all of the characters, maybe. Like tracking down all the characters to get them reunited again. Or it can also be the nostalgia studio thing that Dale works for, because since he, you know, he wants to relive his glory days, so it says that he like works for like this like nostalgia foundation to relive his glory days. And that could be like the headquarters as well. Two theories there. But I honestly am going stronger for the fan theory. Just because I feel like if Dale was like the leader or something, the room would be maybe a little smaller. But I'm not sure. Could be either way. Keep going. See, same thing here. There's lots of like little like things. Like this is a popcorn bucket that they sold in Disney World or Disneyland as well. And then this is a lunchbox, and then these are two like plushy things. I think a fan would have those. Like a fan would like collect them, and it looks like there's two. So it definitely like collected both of them. So I don't think it's like the nostalgic foundation that I was referring to earlier. I think it is a fan's room. Right here, Chip and Dale Rescue Rangers, the original game, came out on NES by Capcom. Came out in 1991, I'm pretty sure. Got that NES right here, right there. There's the game right there. It's really cool to see the game here, because I myself has played it. Good game. So really excited to see that there. I think this shot, the reason why they included it is just to, you know, have another shot of like the fan's room and all the things that the fan is collecting. But I could be wrong. Maybe they go in the video game or something. We're not sure. Here's another shot of the room. Lots of different items here. Lots of like fan items. Even balloons, which are weird. I don't know why there's balloons. It looks like balloons or something. But yeah, more plushies. I think it's a fan room. I think it's a fan's room. A fan's room that had been trying to get them together for years because they want to reboot the show. That's maybe that's what the fan wants to do. And here we go. The first frame that we see of them animated in 30 years, but actually, because they were animated in the 2017 DuckTales reboot, which was animated, that episode that they were in was animated in 2020. So I guess technically first in 2 years, but actually animated for the sake of the actual Rescue Rangers 30 years. So let's like look at them, okay? First reaction. They look fine. Like it's I think it's cel shaded. That's what it is. So it's like this three. It's actually 3D, but it's trying to look 2D. Do I like it? I think it's fun. I think it works for the sake of this movie. I mean, it looks like them from the original show, right? I don't think it looks too awful at all. That's my reaction. And they have everyone, by the way. There was speculation about not having the full cast. Originally, it was only Corey Burton coming back and playing the voice of Zipper over here. That's what I saw in the IMDb a while back. But it looks like they got the full cast. It looks like they have Jim Cummings as well. You'll hear him later. But it looks like they got him back. I'm not 100% sure on that, but if they did, that would be awesome. And Gadget's here. So Gadget, the voice is Trace McNeil. Not really sure, but she was on the official cast, but she wasn't assigned to a role. But, like, I have speculation that she is playing her part, just like she did in the show in the 90s. Can we continue going? Yeah, they look solid. They look solid. I don't know what to say. And here, okay, they're celebrating with all their friends probably to a successful first season. It seems like they were just done filming an episode. This could be the episode with the bank where Fat Cat tries to go in the building right next to the bank to get inside the bank. That could have been that episode. So I think in the movie we're going to see... something like it's gonna maybe it starts off with an actual episode, or in the movie it, you know, it's playing an episode and then it transitions to like the real world. And I think they're now celebrating finishing maybe the first season, and then they're celebrating like, yay, we did so good. Alright, and then this next scene, so these two people, this is from a song. Right? Now that song had this 2D character here, and then this woman.
That's Paula Abdul.
Paula Abdul. The song is called, can we get some research on the song, the song name is? Thank you.
Check and do. What do you want me to?
Oh no, search up 90s song with 2D character. We gotta make sure we get the facts right, folks. Okay, it's called Opposites Attract. That's the song. I knew this familiar, but... Yeah, see, this is where it's from. You can go ahead and pause it. So yeah, from this song. So, reference. First reference that we see, probably other references. But yeah, first reference right there. And basically what this, I think, what this means is that, you know, all the 2D characters that have been, like, made in the 80s, 90s, or... ever are living in our world. I think that's you know what's gonna happen here, and you'll see that. You'll see more characters in a second if you go a little bit more frames. Right, they're dancing, they're celebrating probably their first season. The pigs are from somewhere, I don't know where, but they're from somewhere. And then this is the big thing right here. From where?
They're from like the original like Walt Disney cartoons from like the 30s, I think.
Right. And big thing, Roger Rabbit, right? This is basically, looks like this the closest we're gonna get to a Roger Rabbit 2. And the first one was successful. The first one had all of, you know, all of the animated characters in the real world. So that's what is happening here. Same as Space Jam, they also did in Space Jam with all the 2D characters in the 3D world. But that was like Looney Tunes. But this and Roger Rabbit are both like all characters and all animated things. So that's big right there. That's big. Make sure to watch the movie Roger Rabbit, Who Framed Roger Rabbit, before watching this one. So now what happens here? Little cool, like little Hollywood, just to say, you know, they're in Hollywood because they're big actors now. They just had their show and it was successful. Yeah. And then you can keep going. Yeah, see, like, they're probably at, like, a premiere or something, and in this particular thing, it looks like he's mad, Chip's mad at Dale for being, like, Dale, I don't know, maybe he carries on his persona in real life, right?
It's like a piece of birthday cake. So
yeah,
this
yeah,
is
a piece of birthday cake. This could be after the celebration that they just did, and now they're going to, like, the premiere or something like that. The celebration, I'm saying, is the celebration that we saw just a little bit before, so yeah, you can go ahead and keep going. Yeah, lots of cameras. See, everyone's like, looks like it was big and successful, and then they're gonna take a picture because it's, you know, big and successful, and then they go in the Variety. You'll see right here, and then it transitions from this to black and white. It could all come crashing down, the narrative sense, which I think is alluding to the fact that the show got canceled, and it did get canceled in real life, and they have this 65 episode rule where it's like, once they get the making 65 episodes, then they're like, okay, now we got 65 episodes that we can play in a 13-week period, and yeah, it's that's what Disney usually did, but I think it also did get kind of canceled as well, so they just said they were just gonna stop it. You can go ahead and go.
Oh shit.
Right, 30 years later, so all of the characters now are, you know, they separated, they're on, they're doing their own thing. And we'll see in a second, one of them got a cheese addiction. Right, here's Dan, he's just there. Of course, this is the first time we see him with the CGI surgery. We'll talk about that later. But he's just like, you know, just chilling there, but like, kind of, and then it looks like they're back together for the first time in a long time. And then this is where he says the famous line, hey, it's no secret that I had the CGI surgery. So it seems like he got some surgery done so he can get, you know, CGI, go back a few frames, so we could get, you know, CGI surgery. And it looks like they're kind of distraught. They're like, it's kind of weird, right? It is kind of weird. And this is really important because I think they're kind of talking about how in like the early 2000s when like 3D animation was like still new, and it was kind of crappy when they went from like 2D to 3D. It kind of like sucked for like, I don't know, from like 1998 to like 2005, and then like after that it like actually started being like good. So yeah, I think that's what they're kind of like making fun of, you could say. It's all those, you know, studios going to 3D, same with Disney did it as well. And particularly they did this with Twice Upon a Christmas, which came out in 2004, I believe. And the 3D animation there was not good. And Once Upon a Christmas animation there, it was 2D and it was, you know, it was great, right? So you can keep going. This is when the procedure happens, when Dale does the procedure. This is procedure complete. Got a bunch of things here. It says maybe saline analysis molecular report, V207 or 12. I don't think that's important, but it's just there. And yeah, he completed the surgery.
Zoom into mass range 79 to 90. Gas, plasma off.
Plasma off. Oh yeah, there's a bunch of other things there. Yeah. So now we have this view of this, looks like a hotel, could be also apartments. My guess is that it's Chip's apartment. That's only my guess, and that's like where they all came together for the first time, because they had all come together for some reason, and we'll theorize about that later. But yeah, I think this might be his apartment. Looks like there's also some kind of party going on here. Not 100% sure, but this could be his apartment right there, and they could, I don't know, partying. There could be a scene where they are partying for some reason. This could also be, another theory is it could be Monterey Jack's apartment, and that is the guy that we'll see in a second. He's like the big guy, and he's also addicted to cheese, as we can see here. My love of cheese got the best of me. So he was addicted to cheese, and I think that, you know, he went down a rabbit hole. He went, you know, he wasn't in a good place for after the show got canceled. I think that's what happened. And so this could be his apartment because the cheese was in the fridge, and that would make sense. So yeah, that could be Monterey Jack's apartment as well. We're gonna have to see. And it looks like now they're going probably to where all the mice live. And we see all of the, you know, the drug-addicted mice that are addicted to cheese. So yeah, and Monterey Jack was one of the victims of that, of course. So yeah, here, oh, by the way, this 2D, this is like original 2D, probably from something a long time ago, but this is like really, really interesting to see the almost like the photorealistic 3D and then like the original 2D from like, I don't know, 60s or 70s or whatever, whenever that was made. That's a really cool scene to see. So this is, looks like they took a picture at Disney Let's see, that's World. Yep. Yeah, that's Disney World. They took a picture there. Looks like they're having fun. Maybe they're doing some kind of meetup after the show was popular. And I think right now it looks like this is Dale because he looks like he has CGI. So I think he's looking at the picture and like he's like, oh, I miss that so much. That's why he's working for like the nostalgia thing that he's working for. Right. And then this is also interesting. So they're together. They're probably on their adventure that we'll talk about a little bit later and that we'll see a little bit later. But we see lots of different characters here. So first of all, Borat right here. That is kind of awesome. I'm not sure who this is, but there are a bunch of other characters, maybe popular characters from something else, maybe just random characters. But seeing Borat right there is kind of awesome. Not actually the actor that plays Borat, but it is Borat. And then there's like this lady over here as well.
She's wearing a Batman shirt.
She is wearing a Batman shirt. And it looks like everybody recognizes him from the show and they're taking a picture. And they're taking a picture with everybody.
Oh shit.
Whoops. You can go back a few frames. So yeah, what I was saying is, it looks like they're taking a picture, or like, they notice the characters, and everyone's like, oh my gosh, it's them. And they're like, oh hey, it's us. And maybe, like, it looks like, you know, Dale comes in.
Are destined to reunite.
And, you know, says, hey, let's like pose, and maybe they were like, this hasn't happened in like a really long time, so they're like kind of surprised.
Notice how the animated character has a real life phone.
So the animated character has a real-life phone, it looks like? Let's see, right here?
It's the best show.
Perhaps. It's just a little thing to notice. You know, this is after he got the CGI surgery, of course. Right, and now it looks like Dale is with the pin. Right, he has the pin. And that's like maybe original pin from the show. He's like looking at it. He's like, oh my gosh, I miss that, because you know he misses the glory days, like he says, he does.
I think there's a lot to analyze from this.
From Disney, that's funny because it's like a Disney movie making fun of like the recent Disney remakes, kind of. So yeah, that's it for that frame. Here's something important right here. Like I said, I'm making fun of the recent reboots. Agent says, I'm thinking reboot, and you'll see in a second. Also, is this the villain? Maybe, maybe not. I'm thinking no. There's gonna be some villain that's bigger, but maybe just bad guy in general.
It's an Apple computer there.
This is an Apple computer as well, so they had to pay Apple some money. And then Chip says, nobody wants a reboot. Important. Because this isn't a reboot, this is a comeback, right? So they're kind of saying that. The Lonely Island, guys, the Lonely Island. See, I knew when I saw that they were working on this, I was like, oh wow, this could be awesome, epic. Yeah, I think they kind of did their thing, and we'll talk about that a little bit later. But yeah, as we can see, they kind of like did their thing. You can go ahead and keep going. Here they are in the craft, or the Ranger mobile, or the Ranger plane as well. That's what they're in. It looks like they're flying across. And they were together, of course, and so that's when they were all together and they were going on their adventure. And maybe they had to go to this fan convention that they're at right here. That's maybe where...
It's his fan con.
Yeah, it looks like it's his fan con, Pirates of the Great Lakes. Interesting. Yeah, fan con LA, I think that's where they are.
Holy
and
shit.
This would make sense.
Sailor Moon. You can see Sailor Moon.
Really? So, yeah.
Where?
Everyone is here. The scene that
Where's the stick?
There.
Every you know, everything is here. All animation styles and whatnot is here.
That's crazy. Right.
And I think this is the. It would make sense that this is the same area that they were in when they were posing for that picture. When they were posing for everybody. When everyone recognized them. A little bit earlier in the movie, and here it looks like people are celebrating for them. No, probably something else, but it looks like they're running because they're in the middle of the adventure that they have to save the world from. And then this is like from some anime, and people were going crazy about this on the internet because it's like from anime, so like oh my gosh, this means that like anime is also like real. So yeah, they're running through the comic convention, FanCon, it looks like it's being called. Still got the CGI surgery, that's something to know. He has a CGI surgery. Right, and then he has to go get a disguise, and then he gets the outfit that he wore, minus the thing underneath, but... but yeah, this is basically what he wore with the hat in the original show. And so they're kind of saying like, oh yeah, we recognize it, you know, it actually is from Indiana Jones. And back then they couldn't really say anything, I guess, because, you know, they didn't own Indiana Jones back then. So yeah, now they're like, oh yeah, Indiana Jones. So it was really nice for the real fans to like see that. And then here's Zipper right here with like a little like spark thing like a rocket. Or not a rocket, looks like it's a firework, so it seems like they were all together and they all had to go to this fan con, and like two of them went inside, Jim Dill went inside, and then the others were maybe outside doing whatever, but yeah, I think that's, they had to go to the fan con in order to save something. So yeah, and then here he's on the rocket, he's doing something. He's still got the CGI surgery though. Yeah, rescuing the world, right, they gotta rescue the world, the Rescue Rangers, right? And then this scene, right? This guy, this little guy. I don't know who that is, but it's just, this is a really funny scene because you see all these people with the guns and then this guy. This guy could be the ultimate enemy as well. But I also, honestly, I don't know. Maybe not. You know, maybe it's just like a little goober guy that, you know, it's kind of like maybe a funny character that like is like dumb or something. I don't know. That's just a theory, of course. So yeah, it looks like they're breaching something, or they're...
Going to that secret area, just keep out.
It's just keep out there, so... either they're trying to find somebody or people that were there originally, or they're just going in because there's some kind of entity in there. But I think they were trying to find someone originally, and also there's a dog here, and I think that's 2D.
Yeah, it's 2D because that's like 2D with a 3D vest.
Right. And then now they're in the sewer. So in the original show, they do go in the sewer a lot. So that's kind of nice to see him like in a familiar place. So if you can go back like three scenes. This guy right here, I don't know who he is, but it's there. And it's probably a reference to something. Just a note. There's going to be so many like familiar characters to everybody.
That looks like the skunk from Looney Tunes.
Could be the skunk from Looney Tunes.
The skunk from
my research analysis pointed out that it could be the skunk from Looney Tunes.
Is it the skunk from Over the Hedge?
Could be the skunk from Over the Hedge. I don't think it is, but it could be. That was my second research analysis. And then they both grab this like ball. I don't know where the ball's from, but it's not too important. They grab the ball and
is that the Disney ball?
Could it be the Disney ball?
Can we get an analysis real quick?
My data analysis. My data analyzer says that it could be the Disney ball.
This is a close-up.
Let's see.
Maybe it's the ball from like a paddleboard.
It might have been... Maybe... You know what this could be? Hold on. So keep it here for a second. This could be a joke to where it's like... They might be, oh, that was just conveniently there for us, and how, like, maybe in the show are, like, in a lot of things, and a lot of animated things are just movies and shows. They're just like things that are conveniently there to help the characters like not die or get out of the situation. So they could have been like, "Huh, that was just conveniently there. Would you look at that?" So they could do that, and they would do that, honestly. So I wouldn't doubt it if that's true. Maybe it's not though. It takes a pair. You know, rescuing the world takes a pair. That's what it says.
That's actually a double entendre, because of the common turn of phrase, "Being brave takes a pair," which is in reference to the testicles.
Right.
But it also takes a pair of chipmunks. Speaking
right.
of Chip, as well as Dale.
Correct. So yeah, that's my data analysis, and now my data analyzer. Data analysis person stated that. And here we go. It looks like they're in a little bit of a race car here, right? Probably going to the FanCon thing. Maybe not. Maybe they already have the FanCon. Maybe
they're going because he doesn't have the Indiana Jones yet.
He doesn't have the Indiana Jones yet, so they are going to the FanCon, most likely. Or definitely, they're before the FanCon thing. So, you can continue. Big thing here as well, people on the r/DuckTales Reddit, they were crazy over this. So, I mean, it was inevitable that they were going to show like other Disney Afternoon characters. And here's the first one right here. Of course, in a money bin, it looks like... So if they're going to do the thing where it's like, these are all actors, like all of the animated characters are all actors, and it looks like, you know, in real life, he likes money as well. So yeah, maybe they based the show on him, like maybe it was like a reality show or something like that. That could also be a thing. And also, can you go back a few frames? It could also be possible that we see Hubert Duford and Llewellyn in here as well.
Where?
We can see Hubert Duford and Llewellyn in the movie as well. Just because of the Scrooge McDuck. Maybe they do a little thing, maybe not.
Where were they?
No, they could. It is possible that they could be in the movie, alright?
Wait, who?
Hubert Duford and Llewellyn.
Where?
Duford?
Huey, Dewey, and Louie. The characters from the DuckTales show. They were the kids.
Did you say Duford?
Yeah,
Duford. Is that real?
Yeah, Hubert, Duford, Llewellyn are their real names.
Duford?
Yes, Duford.
Duford. Okay, I'm
My
sorry.
My data analyzer is being done.
I apologize. I'm sorry.
Right,
I'm sorry.
And here we got this big robot thing, right? They're in like some kind of like space vortex. They're probably after the... No, this has... Well, okay.
Oh, wait.
It looks like it's before the Comic-Con thing.
Where are they running to?
And they're running away from lasers, and they're running to, what does that look like? There's a red thing and a blue thing, and those are two colors that are part of the Rescue Rangers, so I don't know. They might be running away from lasers because they're trying to, it's like a security system, so they're breaking into somewhere. That could be a given as well.
And Rescue Rangers 2.0.
And then... Andy Samberg says Rescue Rangers 2.0. I'm not a huge fan of that line, but whatever. Got this lizard thing, so... and then he has a hat on, so that is interesting. Now he has a hat on. Theories, he just puts a hat on because he wants to. Maybe he has to put a hat on for a disguise to get into somewhere where, you know, that could be real. Or maybe he's like in person... Oh, well, it looks like the hat's on forward, so...
I think it's a fedora.
I think it's a fedora?
Yeah, it's a fedora.
I think it's a regular cap, like a baseball cap. Oh, no, I'm sorry. This is a fedora.
Oh,
is a hat that Chip
is
wearing.
Yeah,
because this is Dale, because, of course, CJ had surgery. And then we see Aladdin, of course. Not the actual Aladdin. Or maybe
wait, that is definitely Aladdin. Look, he's
yeah,
fat.
Yeah, it's a little bit bigger. I don't think it's Aladdin.
That's Fat Cat.
Let's see. That's a weird stance for him to be in. There's like a little bit of like a skin color there. So
an interesting little tidbit is that the 2D characters seem to move at a different frame rate than the 3D.
Yeah, that is true. I did see that as well, that they moved at a different frame rate, and I think that's, you know, maybe just to add to the effect, maybe just to make it look a little less 3D-ish because it actually is 3D. So yeah. And then this was a little weird as well. Again, you know, it's a given that all the animated characters are in this thing. And here are them, you know them, right? MLP characters.
Look at Chip's ear.
He doesn't have an ear. Oh, that's interesting.
No, that's Goofy's ear. That's like the dog ear.
Oh, shoot. You know what? You're right. So he has, what might be happening is like, they're like half of, they're maybe, ooh, this could mean a lot of things, but man, they're like forming into other things. Interesting. Probably, and then this is where, the forming idea of like, how you can get the CGI surgery where maybe you can, maybe there are other things where you can like get like upgrades or like you can get other things extended, so there's a lot of different things here. And then earlier we pointed out that this could be the Hunchback of Notre Dame, that's what it looks like here. And then this could be the cat from that cat movie, what was it called?
The Aristocrats.
The Aristocrats.
Cats.
Cats, no.
It's a play on words.
Okay. Wreck-It Ralph, maybe. And it kind of does, like, the shirt, could be. And then this gun, which, did we do any
That would be the Bullet this? Bill from Super Mario.
Okay,
I think that's from, I actually have no idea where that's from. It has to be from maybe like Big Hero 6, man, because it's like, I don't know, it's like a
Big Hero 6, maybe? Alright, our researchers have not concluded something on that. But this could also be, there's a leg that's like
robot.
This, and then there's something in the back there too, that's like 2D. But this could be the villain. And what does it say here? Welcome, Prince
Jolly.
Jolly. So from, is that from,
From In Your Line, it was Prince Ali. Here it says Prince Jolly.
Interesting. Isn't that interesting, huh? So there could be kind of, some kind of like rogue character as well, like some kind of rogue character that's figured out how to like mesh into like different things.
Wait, look at the bottom left corner.
Let's see what this is.
There's like a little purple thingy.
Interesting.
I'm not sure what that is. And then we got the, the logo here. Looks pretty epic. It's updated logo. It's different from the original. I think it, I don't love the font that they went with, like the RR. I don't love the way that looks, but I think it's fine. I like the red and blue and the...
Exclusive side view.
Yeah, there's the exclusive side view. Looks clean, though. Looks clean.
Wait, look at that transition, though.
They could have also,
That transition, though.
That's a good transition, but they also could have... awesome transition. They could have also, the RR could have been from the Chippendale font that they used in the original, the original font for whatever they wanted to do with those fonts. So that's probably what it's from, maybe. I think it's the same font as right here, Chippendale. So yeah, pretty awesome. Not yet rated. Let me do a rating. I think it's going to be PG. Yeah, I don't think it's going to be PG-13. There's no reason why they would do PG-13. If they did PG-13, then, some, like, curse words here and there, and probably won't add to anything. I don't think it needs to be, inappropriate, So, yeah. You can keep going. But it is, I think, the audience is not going to be mainly kids. I think it's going to be, it kind of is really a movie for everybody, now that I think about it. But yeah, here's a lady walking her dog.
But she's not.
And it like looks real, but like it like isn't real. And then Dale mentions that this place looks weird. And then the chick says, "We'll see in a second." Remember that animation style where everything looks real, but nothing looked right. I think he says.
Those are the cats from the Cats
right.
movie.
Right. Yep. This is the cats from the Cats movie.
James Corden.
James Gordon was in it. Corden. I hate that guy.
Why do you hate him?
I hate him. I'm sorry. I mean, he's a fine guy. Like, okay, fine. You make money. You do what you think. But yeah, not a big fan. And this character that like is like really badly animated.
Is that your dad?
No. And this could be like my theory is that it's in like a neighborhood where like.
Watch this.
Like things are like a little off, right? So
here, go back a little and see him walking.
Yeah, so yeah, you can see not walking right, right? So, like, I think maybe the world is going a little haywire, right, with this, with these, like, new, like, 3D stuff. Like, the CGI stuff is, like, ruining the world, maybe, perhaps, and that's, like, messing everything up.
Dale appears to be in some fancy, full
yes,
attire.
Yes, they do, and they're also tied up as well.
New clothes today?
That was the shirt Chip's wearing. He was
yeah,
wearing that.
He was
when
wearing that.
Dale was telling me about the CGI surgery.
New clothes today for Dale.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, those are new clothes for Dale. He got the top hat and stuff. What would that be for? I don't know. I don't really have much theories on that, but definitely a reason for that. He wouldn't be just wearing it, right? Right here we got Bob, right? This is a character Bob, played by Seth Rogen. Interesting. A little bit interesting character. And keep going. Yeah, so it's like a kind of Uncanny Valley as well. That's what the character Bob kind of looks like.
And why are they tied up?
Yeah, why are they tied up? So
they appear to be in some sort of pickle or a conundrum of some sort.
Looks like they're tied up, but they're free to walk around, right? So if they're like tied up and like in a place where they can walk around, and they you know got caught for some reason, but they're tied up and then free to walk around, which is weird. Yeah, so here's Bob, like, you know, like a weird kind of style. It's Seth Rogen, but like different. Not Seth Rogen, voiced by Seth Rogen. Yeah, so basically what they're saying here is that the character looks like, it's looking like eye level to like somebody else, but they're actually way down there.
Making fun of the Uncanny Valley.
Right, making fun of all the like, Uncanny Valley stuff.
The motion capture
tycoon. Yeah, the motion capture tycoon. Yeah, so like the eyes, right?
Like he's doing the peace sign. Sharp pose.
He looks like he's like somebody that is gonna be like, I don't know, a troll? Not a troll, but like someone that says like, okay, you cannot pass, or like if you want to pass, you have to like go through trials, or maybe something like that. I don't know.
Get his hairline though.
Hairline though.
Dale's looking a bit funky. Oh, okay, wait, this is important.
And then he laughs, right, you're in the scene, he's laughing, and then he's in some kind of warehouse, I think now, like, they got into whatever doorstep they were at just a second ago, and maybe they need something in this warehouse in order to get it, so then they can go through their adventure. And there's a bunch of green bins. It looks like there's a green...
This might be porta-potties.
Could be porta-potties. You know what it kind of looks like? That kind of looks like a door. What if it's like the door from like Monsters Inc. or something like that? That would be kind of insane. I don't know.
Read that one. Read those lyrics. What's the importance of that?
Got my best friend. She a real bad. Got her own money. She don't need no...
They seem to be forgetting the last word of each sentence. Do you think that's a creative decision they're making?
It could be a creative decision. Could be. I mean, it has like some kind of like thing as well. Some sort of weapon there. It could be something.
Oh, this is important.
And then this is going to be important as well. So here is a cast. We see the cast here. John Mulaney's Andy Samberg. John Mulaney is Chip. Andy Samberg is Dale. Will Arnett. The IMDb, I think they have a character for him, but I'm not sure. IMDb does not have characters for every single actor.
Eric Banana.
Yeah, I'm not sure about her. Or him, sorry. I thought it said Erica. My bad, Eric. Banana. And then Keegan-Michael Kay. It's really cool. See ya.
Did you know he's going to play Toad in the Mario movie?
He is going to be playing Toad in the Mario movie, and he's also going to be playing somebody in this movie. So, we'll see. We'll see for Keegan-Michael Key. And then Seth Rogen, we just saw as a character Bob. And then who else? J.K. Simmons?
Just kidding.
IMDb probably says something for him. We'll look it up later, though. And then the last one. Kiki Lane. Yeah, I'm not sure about that person either. But we'll look. So
she's probably, what if she plays Gadget?
She played Gadget, but they have Tress McNeil.
Oh, it's the original.
Which is the original voice of Gadget from the show.
Okay, never mind.
And so if she doesn't play Gadget, like, come on, that would be dumb. They gotta get her to play the Gadget. And then, yeah, Disney Plus is streaming only on Disney Plus. But that's not true. It will be in the theaters. Don't worry. There will be a theater that is gonna play this.
Let's get those lights on.
Right, so that was the trailer, and also my predictions as well. They're not solid predictions, they're just predictions based on what we see in the first trailer. Do I think everything I said is accurate now? But I think I got some things that could be real. So here we got a board, and we're going to do a little bit more predictions as well. So here we got the board, right? We're going to do some predictions now. So there are multiple things that I discussed on the through the trailer. So we see the fan con, right?
Full screen it.
Oh, yeah.
This is a horrible marker. Please give me another marker.
Yes, sir.
Do you full screen the top? Is it F11?
Green.
Oh.
Okay, like I was saying, we discussed the fan con. And one of my analysis person, one of my analysis guys is going to be transcribing it onto this paper, not everything, just some things. So, right, like I said, fan con, right? That's going to be a big thing. I think they're going to have to go to the fan con in order to save the world from whatever they got to save the world from. That probably will be the place where they need to go there in order to save the world. So there will be, like, I don't know, maybe that's where everything will go back to normal, right? There won't be any, like, animation styles, like, conform, like, going together like we saw, and the world will go back to normal and be, like, awesome again. So that could be what they are doing with the fan con. But the fan con is important. I think that's going to be, like, you know, the it's going to be an important place. Yeah, so what else?
I just want to let you know we're at 53 minutes.
Okay, thank you. So we also got the fan, right? We didn't see, or at least I don't think we saw the fan in the trailer, but we did see what I think is the fan's room. And my theory with the fan is that the fan trying to get them back together or something is both maybe like a huge fan, but also maybe the villain. Maybe it's the fan is the one that makes the, you know, the animation styles like converging and going together. That could be a theory. And then, let's see. Yeah, like villains. Let's talk about villains. So we just talked about the fan, and then we got another villain. We got the agent. Which I don't really think is going to be the villain, but they definitely go to the agent in order to be like, okay, we're back together again. We need to do a reboot in order to like save the world or something like that. Or maybe it's just they just want to do it again because they all got together, and maybe they all got together because the fan convinced them to get back together and they needed to do a reboot. Or not a reboot, just like get back together and like do something, and then they said they didn't want to do, Chip and Dale both were like, no, we don't want to do a reboot because nobody likes a reboot, that's what they said. So yeah, Asian, probably not a huge big deal. I need another marker. I hate this marker. Please give me another marker. Okay. So other villain. Man, this is nice. That animation conglomerate. So AM for short. Could that be the villain, or could that be like a byproduct of the villain's doing, right?
Why M?
AM.
What does that stand for?
Animation conglomerate. Right? Animation conglomerate, we got that. Could be villain, but byproduct villain most likely. Or is my biggest theory as of right now. Let's erase. Can I get eraser, please? Eraser, please. Do we not have an eraser?
I don't think we actually have an eraser.
Okay, so we don't have an eraser in the studio, so I'm going to have to erase it real fast. Give me a few seconds. Okay, cool. So that's as much as I'm gonna erase it. Okay, no, actually funny, because it needs to be funny. How it's like funny because like.
Sorry, no, I accidentally
funny because
control shift T. I accidentally control.
Okay, so that's how much I could erase it. So we'll just like ignore that. So other things. Let's see.
Other villain.
Is there another villain? Do we have any other villains that we saw?
The guy in the thing, the little goober.
Oh yeah,
okay,
yeah,
segway
character. So SC for short. I really think it's just gonna be like a little goober, like it just is, you know, part of the police force. But you know, it could surprise me. That could be like the villain for some reason. And it kind of looked like a villain entrance as well, like as we saw on the trailer. It really did look like a villain entrance. But yeah, I'm not really sure about that.
What about a twist villain?
Yeah, that could be like the twist villain as well. It could be a twist villain. Can you scroll up so I can see all of the... I mean, scroll down so the whiteboard can be seen. Perfect. So yeah, we got the...
Your phone just died.
Really?
Yeah.
Can you hold on your phone? I'm not done. I can't finish like this.
Okay. What if my phone also dies? Well, can we just have the one?
Yeah, we'll have the one for the rest. Well, I think we got enough shots for that. So yeah, those are all the villains that we have. And I think it's gonna go like the plot is gonna be like, you know, one of those like plot things, right? It's gonna do that, right? There's gonna be things. And then right at the top is gonna be the fan con, right? So I think that's all there is to say about that for right now. Let's go for some reactions on the internet. Let's see some reactions on the internet. So if we could go to the right. So here, no. Someone says, "Holy f, this is trash." When I posted, okay, no, no more, please. It's actually like it's okay. It's funny, but like. It's funny if, like, no, like, funnies, right? It's funny if serious. Okay, go back to the original document. Alright, so we're gonna go see some online reactions, right? Online reactions. This is online reactions. This is what we're gonna do right now. Someone says, this is trash, and, yeah, Dumbatic Cat. Says that this is trash, and I say to him, you gotta see it through their eyes, like, it's a lonely island working on this, I don't think there's any better way that they could have done it. I think what they are gonna go for is nice. I think it's gonna be turn out good. Why do they have to do their thing, he says? Well, because that's who the Lonely Island are, you know, they do things like that, you know, and they make it their way, and you know, some people are saying that it's too far from the source material. They say this here, no they did not, but some people say it's too far from the source material, and I don't think that's really true. I think there's going to be some nostalgia factors, right? But again, like, there's this, like, some people are saying it can't rely too much on nostalgia, and I agree. If it relies too much on nostalgia to make a good movie, then it's not the greatest movie. But there will be definitely some nostalgia factors. Nostalgic factors.
Next. Reddit or
no? So, yeah, and then I you know, I kept trying to convince him to, like, give it a chance, and he said he wasn't going to watch it, so I was like, oh, whatever. We can go to the Instagram account now, if we can click on there. So this is Instagram account. They posted the trailer, and then here are some comments. Like, this one says, you guys ruined it. It's not even that hard. Not really sure what they're talking about there. That wasn't a really popular comment, but... And then this people said... You guys ruined my favorite Disney characters. You could have made this film with a character like Roger Rabbit.
Well, look at
and
this. She's back as Gadget.
It's satire. That you're using the characters, but why Chip and Dale? Well, why Chip and Dale? Because that's the movie that they decided to make, and they were going to make an origin story. That's what they were originally going to do back in 2014 when they decided to work on this movie, I think. And then they turned the director to Avika Shafar. I'm pretty sure, sorry, I'm probably butchering that. But yeah, they turned it over to him, and they decided to do something completely different, just like Roger Rabbit. And that's why it's their characters, because that's just a movie they were working on next, and I think it's going to work out, you know. And it's just fun to see it not just be Roger Rabbit 2, just, you know, some other characters. That's what I think. Maybe people don't agree with me on that, but that's just a small thing. Yeah, Tress McNeil is back with Gadget, I hope. And we can keep, I don't know what they're saying. Yeah, people are going, you know, they're like, oh my gosh. Yeah, I didn't expect the meta angle, like, when I first found out about this, but then when I saw when the little man was part of it, I was like, okay, I knew they're going to go meta with it, because they do things like that. We can keep going. This guy says, yes, awesome. Keep going down. Keep going. See, okay, so... Ordinary, boring, maybe, but a lot of people on the internet are complaining that the voices are not sped up. And what I say to that, and what some of my partners are saying, some of my analysis people are saying, is that there could be a joke that they... You pitched up their voices for the actual show, and their voices in real life are different. And I also do think that the voices are fine. Yeah, they're both famous voices. Sounds a little weird. I mean, it doesn't sound boring like someone who just said, I think they're fine. But people have strong opinions about not having their voices pitched up. But honestly, I think that would have got annoying, in my opinion. I think it would have been annoying to hear that pitched up voice, like the album Chipmunks. And so I'm kind of glad that they didn't, but I wasn't sure what they were going to do originally, if they were going to pitch up or not. So yeah. Voices said no, and then people are just like, I hate it. Like, not even giving it a chance, and they can't do that. So those are just some of the complaints. The voices was a big one, and then being too far away from the source material was also a big one. But yeah, too far away, I don't think it's going to be too far away, but we'll just have to wait and see, really. Like, the initial reaction was, oh, this looks like, what, this looks promising. They were like, oh my gosh, this is like something different and like meta. And then some people were like, oh, this looks awful. Like, some of the fans on the actual subreddit, the Rescue Rangers subreddit, were like, oh, this looks awesome. I mean, awful. And it's, like, far away from what it originally was, and I'm not going to watch it. And it would have been better as, like, an origin story. I don't think it would have been that good as an origin story. Also, yeah, maybe people would appreciate that. You know, the long-term fans would have appreciated the origin story. But it wouldn't have appealed to everybody. So yeah, well, it could have, but yeah. It would have been interesting to see, but there was already an origin story in the original, so it would have honestly been a reboot. And they're doing something different, so I like that. So, we'll go to the official poster now on the r/movie subreddit. Just some more stuff that we'll look through. It looks more like Roger Rabbit 2, and yeah, it kind of does, you know? But that's not like a bad thing. Maybe it is to some people. Let's see what else. Yeah, so basically, wait, real quick. I really like seeing this. They live a life of mediocrity.
What?
they live in a world where humans and cartoon characters live together, just like Roger Rabbit universe. Meanwhile, traditionally animated characters are doing their best to live in a world of remakes and reboots with realistic computer graphics. So, the realistic computer graphics, like the CGI surgery, right? That's like maybe the thing that is, you're ruining the world. You know, maybe there's some kind of boss guy that like is like, oh, do the CGI thing, and people are doing it, and it's like messing up their, it's messing up everything. And then, I think it's really funny how, if we go to the IMDb, actually, can you search up the IMDb? We'll end on the IMDb here. No, that's the original. Did you go to this one here?
Clicking it.
Alright.
There we go.
Right. Gonna be released May 20th. I guess. So, okay. So here, as we can see, let's see. J.K. Simmons is not assigned to a role. Same with her. And then, same with the voice actor of Gadget in the original one. Don't know why, but also I would like to mention, because of this, we see that there is going to be a flashback to school, I think. So if we scroll down a little bit, it says young Dale, and then also there's a young chip up there, I think. But and a girl in the classroom, I think it's going to be, there's going to be like a school scene. So it is kind of going to be, you know, there will be flashback scenes, and I think that's going to be interesting too, like before the show, which is interesting. I think it's going to be cool. So that's kind of the origin story. You know, maybe they'll have some origin story elements in there. So that's what we see here. And I just have, like, one last theory, is that this man and chipmunk costume, it's going to open with, like, the man and chipmunk costume. I think that's just a theory, that it's going to open with, like, him just in the chipmunk costume being like, yeah, whatever. That dude, this person. Suburban domesticity is what it says for Chip. What did he, like, got, just search up, article, search up Chip Rescue Rangers in the same movie. I had the tab open earlier, but I closed it.
Insane, what?
Insane, just insane movie. Go down. I clicked on the link before. I had it open, maybe. Just search up the Rescue Rangers, and then instead of insane, just do movie. And then go down. It was like an article, so. We'll actually just go to the Wikipedia, which is like the first thing right here. Right there, Wikipedia? Yeah. Right, so Dale had the CGI surgery, I think that's funny. Okay, so here's the important thing. Dale works at the convention in hopes of reliving his glory days. So that was the thing when I was saying, like, the nostalgic committee thing. That was it. And it doesn't say where. Oh yeah, Chip works as an insurance salesman, and it says somewhere else that he gave into suburban domesticity, and he started to work as an insurance salesman. So I think that's interesting to see that 30 years later that they're doing that. So that's all I wanted to point out there. All
right, final thoughts.
All right, so now final thoughts. Give the movie a chance. Be optimistic about it. Right, and yeah, I think that's honestly it. If you just like, just give it a chance, watch it when it comes out. I don't think there is much else to say, really.
So just do Chippendale.
No, because I want to, like, if they're like, I'm Alvin and the Chipmunks, I'm like, no, you're the dumbest person alive. Because you need to watch the new Rescue Ranger movie. Have you heard about the new movie coming out? Have you heard about the new movie coming out? Seriously. Why? Well, hello?
I think they're frozen.
Oh, okay. That'd be funny if they were just like, still.
Hello.
Have you heard about the new movie?
What?
The new movie.
What movie?
It's called Rescue Rangers. Have you seen the trailer?
Of course.
What?
Have more.
Have you heard about the new movie?
Which?
It's called Rescue Rangers. Very nice. You should go see the new movie trailer.
Yeah. New movie. What's the name of it?
The name is Chippendale Rescue Rangers.
Raise it up a little bit. Perfect.
That's the new movie.
Rangers.
Have a wonderful day.
Yes, thank you. Nice to meet you, boy.
Oh, I can't hear you. What?
The new trailer?
What, for Rocket?
No, for Chippendale Rescue Rangers. The new trailer just dropped.
Oh.
It's a really meta movie. It's a movie making fun of other movies. You should check it out. It's awesome. You're very good at Rocket League. You should check out the trailer.
I'm very shit.
No, you're very good.
I'm very shit, bro.
Where are you from?
UK.
UK? Thought so. Not in the best way. Don't mind my friend's farts. So yeah, check out the trailer. It's actually awesome. You're very good at what you do. Keep doing what you do. Goodbye. Have you seen the new trailer? Oh, it's you guys. Have you seen the new trailer? I want someone to watch it live, and then like I'll like tell them about it while they're watching it live. Have you seen the new trailer?
What?
New movie trailer just dropped.
Yes.
You seen the new Rescue Rangers trailer?
No.
You should go watch it. It's really good.
Okay. I will do that.
Thank you. New movie just dropped.
What one?
It's called Rescue Rangers.
Rescue what, sorry?
Rescue Rangers.
What's that about?
It's about, it's basically a movie making fun of other movies. So.
Oh, that sounds actually pretty fun.
It is. You should watch the trailer. It's awesome.
Wait, is that actually being serious?
Yes, it's a real movie.
I thought you were joking.
No, it's actually like a real movie.
What's it called again?
Rescue Rangers.
Oh, I bet it's like a porno or something.
No, it's not. I promise.
Is it on YouTube? Can I watch it on YouTube?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. See if this is some... See if I'm going to watch like something mad.
No.
Are there? If it's gonna look, that one.
Yes, that one. Yeah. It's based off of a show from the 90s, but it's like they basically went meta with it, and now they're it's gonna be like self-aware and stuff, and it's making fun of other movies. So, yeah, it's kind of interesting. It like looks like a children's movie, but it like isn't at all.
no secret that he got the CGI surgery.
Sorry?
It's no secret that he got the CGI surgery. I love that line, it's so funny. Exactly, right? That's what I'm saying. It actually looks like it's gonna be good.
Yes,
it does. Mm-hmm. No, it's May 20th. No, May 20th. Yeah.